Genie Flickner. Weather with Bryan Schuerman. And sports with Trent Love.
Tonight, hundreds of people in Illinois are working to pick up the pieces after a devastating tornado tore through their town. One silver lining of the tragedy, though, many people survived the wrath of Mother Nature thanks in part to better technology that's helping meteorologists give more accurate and advanced warnings when dangerous weather is approaching. Meteorologist Bryan Schuerman joins us now live in our studio to talk about those types of warnings and just how important they are in these types of situations. Bryan.
Well, Jeannie, we say it all the time when tornado warnings are issued. Move to the lowest floor of your home, away from windows. And in situations like yesterday, below ground was the place to be. Meteorologists started to warn about the potential for this violent weather situation that could unfold a few days before it happened. And even though the warnings were issued and the sirens sounded, we're still dealing with the loss of life. One person died in this tornado in Washington, Illinois. And as folks continue to take stock of the damage, residents are looking ahead to the rebuilding process.
Over 24 hours after a violent tornado outbreak struck the midwestern portions of the United States, folks in Illinois, Indiana, and Kentucky are still coming to terms with how this happened before the cleanup can begin.
And I said, this isn't right. I said, it's not thunder, it's not, and it just kept coming, getting louder. And so then I went in the basement, and about 10 seconds later, I felt the house shaking, and waited about probably a minute. Then I came back up and saw what you're seeing here.
And we just stood in the hallway where there were no windows and just held each other. It was that quick.
And even as an EF4 tornado was tearing through central Illinois, one man who survived the storm says even though he was taking shelter, he could feel his house falling apart around him.
I could feel everything that was hitting me. I knew it was cinder blocks and I knew it was trusses. I knew, you know, it was just very surreal. And at one point I thought I was a goner.
And as folks begin the process of rebuilding, this community might have been shattered by a storm, but is one that could never be torn apart.
We're a resilient community. We're going to try to bounce back from this. Ran into one of the football coaches, one of my tours today. Asked him about the game, and he said, the kids don't care. They're worried about their community. That's what this community is about.
And even though homes have been reduced to piles of splintered wood, this community is still intact in the ways that really matter. Meteorologist Bryan Schuerman, WHAG, your local weather leader.
National Weather Service meteorologists say they will be